Emmanuel Macron, leader of France. He became president as a possibility of bringing something audaz and young and a breath of fresh air in the midst of all parties. Now things aren't so nice. Everything seems associated to the symbols of protests that they have ongoing. These protests have had them away from the foreign policy. Not far away, not long ago, he came back to promote the European policy and not allow Europe to go down the path of the Brexit. He tried, his main objective is to promote Europeanism. And now he has problems with some differences with Germany. This in the midst of the countdown to have elections as a, for European Parliament. The role of France, the participation of Macron, this is what we're going to see today.
Hechos noticiosos, actores involucrados, sus respectivos.
We're going to see mainstream news and this analysis. Thank you for watching us. Let's see. Emmanuel Macron has been 2 years since he was elected president. Analysis that say that his popularity is going downstream. And some main points are because of the salaries that are down. We've got yellow vests that have been 27 weeks already protesting, while Macron insists that he's going to be the savior of the Europeanism. An option would be to win the elections of the European Council. The yellow vests, he said the following. Personally, I think that the answer to this movement was already expressed in the press conference. And I think for those who keep on expressing themselves, there is no way out. We've done our work, and I think that now everybody should go vote in elections. When we have ideas, you have to present yourself to elections. That's much easier. It's much easier to present opposition, but that doesn't help. Now I see many people who oppose. What I ask is to be calm, serenity. There's too much violence in our society. There are some, the elections for the European Council are going to be a poll on his approval and disapproval. And he says that the media is on the ultra-right. We've been for months explaining that we cannot vote, that we cannot vote against Le Pen, that we have to work for the people that want a reduction of the working hours and increase of the salary, not like Le Pen that opposes what I've just said. Just lately, we received an awful bomb, a clown that just says that the National Coalition is in the position to defeat Macron. Protests do not stop. There have been several protests in France against the law of public policy. What does the workers' union say? They say that that would be put in risk 120 workplaces. For the first time, all of the working unions got together against the policies. The last protests were headed by the drivers.
No entiendo. Estamos en
I don't understand. We're in France.
Estamos en un país de derechos.
We're in a country of rights.
Está obligando a respetar la
However, we have to, we
no
have to respect rights.
A los Uber.
We're not paid
no
enough. Uber drivers are not paid
no
enough.
Eso.
This is not possible.
Y hoy estamos en las calles.
And now we're
es
in the streets. It's because we're sick of this for years.
Sus promesas de campaña, las de
Their
Macron,
no election promises does not go along with what he's done in the first 2 years. These are the demands in the streets. This is why he's faced crisis of great magnitude and put at risk his government.
Primero de enero de 2018, protestas de pensionistas.
2018, como consecuencia directa de un aumento en 25% de impuestos.
La medida afecta al menos a 16 millones del sector, que representa 24% de la población.
Which 4.500 millones de euros saldrán
de los bolsillos de los pensionistas para cancelación de impuestos. El Ejecutivo aprobó reducciones del mismo monto, pero a favor del sector empresarial, es decir, a favor de quienes más tienen. Como medida de presión ante el rechazo de las modificaciones que pretendía ejercer la administración francesa
Trump a través de una administration reforma que entre otros puntos
planteaba la privatización
de la empresa de transporte the railroad organization.
Septiembre-octubre 2018, renuncia de ministros claves. La dimisión del titular de medio ambiente, Nicolás Hulot,
del deporte
de Laura Flessel y el interior Gerald Colón, ocurrió justamente cuando el Elíseo era el centro de un escándalo.
One was the Minister of Interior and the other one of Environment.
Agredió físicamente a un manifestante.
There was a big uproar because of the chief of security
had
attacked a protester.
Chalecos amarillos.
October 2018, Yellow Vests is one of the main movements with political projections.
Espontáneas en las que se usaban prendas con amarillo fluorescente.
With unorganized protests, but then they began to be organized. They protest against the rising prices of gas.
Sociales y políticas. Exige incluso la renuncia de Macron.
They demand the ousting of Macron.
Las agresiones y abusos policiales.
Thousands have been victims of their aggressions on behalf of the police.
La renuncia del ministro de Interior Christopher Castaner, al considerar
Christopher Castaner, the Minister of Interior, has been demanded to withdraw because of the violence against the Yellow Vests. Journalists Without Frontiers have announced that several journalists have been
3 de diciembre de 2018, reforma educativa. El proyecto de ley que acarrió una ola de manifestaciones y dejó 700 estudiantes detenidos. Plantea la disminución de las horas académicas y las técnicas profesionales a casi 300 horas anuales, lo cual conlleva una baja calidad de formación de los alumnos.
Which lead in time to a decrease of the quality of education.
También la disminución de 1.500 empleos administrativos.
1.500 workplaces would be destroyed.
15 de abril de 2019, incendio de Notre Dame. Las llamas de un
incendio inesperado consumieron el estado de la historia
arquitectónica gótica durante una fatídica tarde de abril.
Historical architectural
aportaron generosas donaciones para la reconstrucción.
Was destroyed. And President asked for support for its
resupport.
However, there was a lot of protest because all of the money that poured in instead of going to other priorities.
Tituló este 20 de mayo,
May 20th,
entra en recta final headline, hacia elecciones europeas en
the headline
Francia.
Said. European elections are in the countdown. Next Saturday, the elections will be held to designate the main authorities for the European Council. 31 lists of parties have been approved. In France, 34 parties are going to participate. Some are just recently created, like the ones of the Yellow Vests. Every list is made up of 79 members, and the main support has the movement of the president. And the ultra-right, the party of Marine Le Pen is heading with 41%.
La misma prensa.
However, the same press later changed the data where both Le Pen and Macron are tied for first place.
According to Ipsos,
the organization of Marine Le Pen, there's 35%, just half a point in front of the organization of Macron, which only has 23%.
Me voy ahora a la vanguardia.
Let's go to the vanguard of Spain.
Publica o publicó el día 10 de mayo, España quiere ganar.
On May 10th, they published that Spain wants to advance positions in the European Union.
El pistoletazo de salida a la carrera para renovar los principales gobiernos cargos de la Unión Europea. Un paquete de puestos de
27 parties are trying to look for positions in the European Party.
Consejo, Parlamento, además del
of the Council of Parliament, the Bank, and the High Commissioner.
En cumbre extraordinaria el próximo 28 de mayo.
This starts on 28th of May. This is exactly 2 days after
España,
of the European elections. Spain, with Pedro Sánchez at the head, wants to be the leading force.
En esa cumbre de
primer día de mayo, of the first days of May,
tres grandes prioridades o
three great priorities are being stated.
España con Pedro Sánchez planteaba tres grandes prioridades:
España states,
crecimiento económico, apoyo al empleo,
economic growth, support to work,
climático,
and
bueno,
fight against climate change.
Habla
this is the main agenda, and this speaks about how there's a fight about the agenda.
Me voy a la Red Voltaire.
Let's go to Red Voltaire, Voltaire Network. Some weeks ago, they published on May 7th this that is titled European Union Right Now and as an Option for the Future. This is a complete analysis that this media has. And what they say is that the European Union members and the citizens are called to elections.
Vacilan entre varias prioridades, pero
several
si
other priorities,
de su historia, podrían descubrir
but if they analyze this, they could find the origin of their problems.
Duda,
and without a doubt, their decisions would be different.
De los 28 países demuestra que
the block of the 28 countries
para favorecer los intereses de los pueblos europeos, sino para
are going to fight for their priorities and get away from Russia. They've never fought for peace or for economical worth. They've just fought for their own interest. What does this have to do with the role
Europa
that Europe plays
in the
in important jointures
ente supeditado
like an institution
los intereses
that's submitted
de los
to the interests of the United
bueno,
States?
Vamos a
well,
con
let's connect
desde
with
España.
Other events.
Sergio Rodrigo, corresponsal de esta casa.
I want to talk to Sergio Rodrigo, who's a correspondent
Sergio.
From Spain. Spain, Sergio.
Muy buenas, un saludo muy fuerte a toda la audiencia de Telesur.
Good afternoon.
Emmanuel Macron
in fact, Emmanuel Macron became,
May 14th, became the president of France
with a recently created party. The project that he had on the way was tightly connected with the banks and wanted to struggle against the bipartisan struggle in Europe. His main objective was to stop the insubmissive France who keeps on growing and growing that would oppose the extreme right of Marine Le Pen, who came strongly second.
He was the main
candidate of the opposition. However, the economic measures based on neoliberalism have led his popularity to go just above 20%. There have been crises like the Yellow Vest who have marked his presidency, and the Workers' Union has rejected his proposals. And the most important point is privatization of the railroad. All of this has led to non-stop protests. Macron has become one of the most of the poster boy for Europeism. However, with their problems within, including migration, this interior crisis is based on the vulneration of rights for the workers. Thank you, Sergio.
Escuchándole a Sergio Rodrigo,
while I was listening to Sergio, I was writing down, what does Macron symbolize for Europe?
Ciertamente es la salvación del europeísmo.
In fact, is he a breath of fresh air for Europeism, as he presented himself when he won as a young, audacious president?
lo evaluamos junto a nuestros
analistas. Let's evaluate with this with our analysts.
Mientras hacemos nuestra primera pausa en la jugada crítica. Espérenos.
Let's go to a pause. We'll be right back.
La figura de Macron, rol de Francia en Europa,
the image of Macron and the future of the European Union is what we're going to be analyzing.
With our Emmanuel Macron
leads the French presidency, and from the most poorest person to the middle class have led since several months protests, continuing protests.
Los trabajadores ferroviarios han protagonizado casi 10 huelgas nacionales contra el intento de privatización ferroviaria y la eliminación de su estatuto laboral. Además, Macron quiso disminuir 60,000 millones de euros del presupuesto ferroviario. Por su parte, los estudiantes financieros y asíntomas de facultades y multitudinarias marchas contra el intento de generar criterios meritocráticos para ingresar a las casas de estudio. Sin duda, uno de los ataques más fuertes contra los trabajadores ha sido la reforma attacks
is the workers' reform that's called XXL because of the magnitude of the measures. The plan includes the elimination of 120,000 workplaces in the public administration. The reform tries to flexibilize companies and includes limits to the severance pays and the possibility that companies can negotiate individually with each worker their conditions. This limits the workers' union. On the other hand, they also increased attacks on the pensions. And he said that it's because the pensioners charge too much. Many of these retired went out to protest. This affects 16 million people who are retired, who represent 24% of the population. Confronted with all these measures, it is also added the increase of the gas prices, which fostered the creation of the yellow vests, and now corners the French president.
Como es costumbre, después de nuestra primera pieza de contexto, sumemos las consideraciones que tienen a bien ofrecernos sobre esta jugada.
Let's see what our guests say. They're both French, connecting from France, Paris.
Sociólogo responsable para América Latina y el Caribe de Relaciones Internacionales.
We have with us
y Romain Migu, sociólogo, periodista y analista.
Two analysts.
Bienvenidos, gracias por atendernos. Y en el orden en que les presenté, les pregunto.
Let me ask you.
Cristian, queremos mirar primero lo que simboliza la figura Macron.
What does the image of Macron symbolize for France and for Europe? A man who rose very rapidly and was able to channel all of the needs of the France. But however, his popularity is going in decrease. How do you see it? Why is this happening?
Hola, buenos días.
Hi, good morning.
Y a ti en especial, estamos de nuevo juntos. Te respondo a tu pregunta.
Let me answer your question.
Decirte que el personaje Emmanuel Macron,
tell you that Emmanuel Macron
y creado por was a el gran capital,
built up
el gran capital financiero francés,
character.
Un hombre que aparece con una carrera.
He was a man who appeared
muy corta,
with a very short political history and very close to the bank.
De la noche a la mañana,
and
un discurso,
from one day to another, he came up with this speech against the political parties and pro to the movements.
Hay que tener confianza en sí mismo.
We must have faith in each other.
Ese discurso que pegó muy
this speech that was good for elections
was the one that allowed him to become president.
Tiempo, lo sabíamos, pero lo confirma mucho.
However,
sobre todo un libro que ha provocado mucho impacto, que es el libro de Juan
there was
Branco,
a book about Juan Branco.
Creo que ustedes han entendido. Hablar está gratuitamente en sitio internet.
And the book is free on internet.
Que viene de yo mismo, y donde cuenta
and what he says is that
por detalles,
he details, point by point, how Macron was built for the election. Let's remember that he was part of the socialist movement before. And when he reaches the presidency, he comes with the speech. I've always said it before. Sort of like a Macri.
And they're both
among the poorest presidents evaluated by the people. And the only thing that sustains Macron is the financial and the media power, which is concentrated no more than seven families who control absolutely everything. Thank you for your opinion. Let's go with our second guest. Do you agree? Could you tell us if Macron has disarmed the country of welfare? Well, I think that the previous guest has made a great introduction on how he appeared.
Esta acción del gran capital, como
I would just say that
Cristian
this
Rodríguez,
grand capital
se enmarca en un momento de desprestigio total de los partidos políticos
in the midst of a moment
entonces,
where all the parties were totally disprestiged. So what did Macron do?
Robar,
he
no?
just stole great part of the votes of the electors who traditionally voted for the social democracy or for the social liberalism. This was very important because he has an electoral base. He still does. I think that in this case, there's a mistake to say that he's only sustained by the capitalism and the media, because he's going to go to these Sunday elections and he still will be first or second in the elections. This means that there is an electoral base in France, and I would even say in Europe, that is pro-privatization, pro-liberalism, and that wants to break with this government of welfare that was traditionally part of the French policy.
Macron no tiene ningún tipo de complejo.
Macron,
digo Macron cuando hablo de presidente Macron, yo hablo del sistema.
Has no problem. When talking about Macron, I'm talking about the system he represents.
Que se hace el eco de los grandes empresarios o sector financiero.
Of the great companies that support him. Obviously, the electoral base who support him, and also the sector that is reflected within the European Council, which is the one who plans the policies for the member countries.
Therefore,
all of this is giving an attack going to another model that normally used to go, that was the study of, that was a country of welfare. This was a model where the relationship with work has changed. This also explains why, in this moment, we're in Europe, we're living all of these defeats. In the last 10 years, the system has been totally attacked. Beyond left or right, the system has been attacked. There have been movements in the streets. There have been the unions in the streets too. But the end, we use the rules of the European Union. So we're faced with a very complex situation that obviously has a great impact in the future of France, and obviously in a couple of days in the elections.
preguntarte sobre lo que estabas desarrollando en esta primera respuesta. Ciertamente dices que tienes a Macron el gran capital, pero refieres que no solamente.
Macron is not only supported by the great capital, but he also has a great electoral base. I would like to know how is this explained and what happens with the rest of the society that demands be heard and be considered. It's been already 2 years of confrontation, and France is far more fragmented. Yes, in fact, I think that there's a recomposition of the political field, and this has been totally understood by Macron and the people who support him. There's a recomposition that we could even compare to the one that was lived in Latin America in the 90s and at the beginning of the years 2000. We're seeing the growth, the development in an initial way in Europe, a liberal field, a patriot and elitist group. With the difference that in France, this group was divided in two, l'Assemblement National and another part, La France Insoumise. And what is, at the end, what they were seeking is that there's been a confrontation.
A este modelo o a este campo liberal está muy fragmentado. Y
so there's been a fragmentation.
De las leyes electoral francesa,
so Macron, this has been to the benefit
si bien solo tiene
of Macron. And if true, Macron only has the support of 10 or 15% of the registered voters, but he always has an advantage in front of the division of their counterparty.
Christian,
could you please tell us?
Dice Romain, surge un campo liberal, un oligarca y un patriota. Es la
that there's been three fronts here.
Que él hace.
That's how he identifies it. How do you see it?
Campo político y social francés está recomponiendo de esa manera.
Do you think there's a recomposition in this sense with the three movements?
Yo creo que la
Listen,
solución
I think that the solution
a
to this structural solution to crisis.
El capitalismo. En todas partes, tú lo ves como en América Latina,
you can see how
retomada,
everywhere, all around the world, Latin America, they're trying to revive the neoliberal decade. In Europe,
resolviéndose hacia,
is trying to go
impulso de políticas,
towards policies that are neoliberal and have already failed before.
También fracasó y la experiencia ustedes lo conocen mucho más Latinoamérica que nosotros.
Latin America knows this experience much clearer than we.
Que trae este nuevo capitalismo
that this old capitalism comes
hacia la extrema derecha.
Is taken by the extreme right.
Extrema derecha, la más burda.
The most
y ese es el campo que
extreme.
Está ganando, donde
and that's the that's where they're growing.
Es el enemigo extranjero llamado emigrante, donde
and
el tema
main,
del empleo, donde el tema
a main element here are the migrants.
No son preocupaciones absolutas para una sociedad de la que nosotros esperamos.
This
Entonces,
is,
yo no creo que
I don't believe
tiene que ver patriotas versus no patriotas.
That it has to do patriots against non-patriots. Because we have nothing to do with the extreme right. In the model, in the economic model, in the social model, what we're saying is that in the popular field,
well,
we want to know, are we able to construct a new alternative to everything that's old?
Macron
maintains there's a tendency there. I think that economic right has a weak political aspect. But it's sustained by the force that the economical force has. To say that there's no other option.
We,
as the unsubmissive France, we think that we need unity.
por la izquierda, si tú quieres,
that we have to go through the left,
por el mundo
through the social movements,
no por la derecha.
Not through the extreme right.
Ahora, Christian, ha hecho de Europa uno de sus caballos de batalla.
He's made of Europe one of his main goals.
Por decirlo de alguna manera.
Europeism.
Habla y escribe del renacimiento europeo.
He writes and he talks about the rebirth of Europe.
Que lucen como la gran prueba para él, porque espera que las elecciones.
Because with these elections, they're a great poll for him.
Que parece estar perdiendo, pero es que también para
it will legitimize his position.
Como lo desea Macron, a juzgar por su vocería, por
judging
sus acciones,
by what he says,
escribe, necesita una sólida presencia en el Parlamento regional. No lo cree así, ¿cómo piensa Macron
parliament?
En ese escenario continental?
How does this go for Macron?
Mira, yo creo que Macron,
listen,
supuesto liderazgo,
I think that Macron,
un gran, una gran falsa noticia.
Alleged leadership,
diríamos, ¿no?
In
Europe sería un porque
is not so.
Histórica alemana francesa es absolutamente falsa.
Because this union between France and Germany is not so. At one point we thought that France and Germany were the ones who were directing Europe. This was when, this was before. Not now, when there are more than 28 states. I think that what that the dispute that, that Macron is doing, with the dispute he has with Merkel, it's like marriage. One day they're boyfriends, next day they're not. It's a love-hate relationship. And what he has to do
y eso lo hace muy mal,
is to create alliances. However, he has not been able to do so. He has not been able to do with Spain, with Portugal.
Neoliberalismo brutal. Tiene lo más reaccionario, que yo diría Hungría, tiene lo más reaccionario.
He has Hungary,
está en toda esa zona de los países
who is in all of that area.
Evidentemente, toda la encuesta lo da como ganador.
All of the surveys make him a winner for these elections.
Vamos a tener
him and all his movements. We're going to have to fight and keep on fighting because apparently we have not been able to break this unity of this project of neoliberal project, which is nothing else than just selling the country.
Gracias, Cristian. Vuelvo con
Thank you, Cristian. Let's go back to Romain for a last question.
¿Quieres añadir tu visión sobre las parlamentarias?
Do you have anything to add about the parliamentary elections, France in general? And if you could help us with the role of the news outlets. Maybe they're not all the same, but apparently they're betting on the image of Macron. I would like you to precise this.
Yo creo que puedes meterlos todos
I think that you can put them all in the same bag. Since in France, they all belong to 10 multimillionaire people who financed Macron's campaign. So obviously you can put them all in the same bag.
Incluso los medios de servicio público que hacen una propaganda
you can even say that the public service media are also into this. I think it's important to add that we're not in a simple national election. So what I'm saying is the people who are presenting themselves with a party trying to get to the European Parliament are forming alliances within parliament groups. However, very probable that the Macron group, who are the European liberals, may be an ally with the Popular Party and with the Social Democracy in Europe. This bloc, this liberal bloc, will even have the support of some green liberals, will be a majority in the European Parliament. Therefore, so if the group of Macron isn't literally the winner, but
contra de esta ideología.
The movement will be imposed.
Va a haber un grupo lamentablemente reducido
there will be a small
populista de
minority
izquierda, ¿no?
Of the left.
De gente de izquierda y un grupo extremadamente dividido
and an extremely divided group
de derecha.
Populist
no
group of the right.
Hay muy pocas cosas que ver entre,
there are
por ejemplo,
just a few
Dr.
things
Bar,
to see,
Pen,
a couple of cases.
Los austríacos, o sea, hay división interna.
There's interior division in this camp of what Christian calls the extreme right.
Muchas diferencias.
But there's many differences.
Por ejemplo, hay una parte de
for example,
que son
there's a part of them who are very liberal.
Orbán, por ejemplo, que son
extremely liberal.
De Estados Unidos contra Rusia,
and who are very close to the Russia and American interests.
And
there are other groups of the same group
Rusia,
who are more, who are closer to the other side. As you can see, when I was talking about interior divisions, I was talking about at the national level, this will repeat itself on the European level. And I think that, in fact, the liberal ideology will impose itself in the European Parliament without there being a single force strong enough to change from the inside the circumstance.
Seguramente, gracias Romain.
Thank you very much, Romain. Just one last question, Christian. So, what's going on with the left? What's happening with it today? Well, it's not doing well.
Bastante dividida.
It's very divided.
Bueno, en general en esta elección hay 35 listas.
Well, in general, there's 35 parties who have presented themselves. We expect that the reason prevails for the most of the unsubmissive parliamentaries to get into the European Parliament.
Es muy fuerte. Nosotros lo hemos dicho.
How, we've said it before, that the social democracy has done extremely bad, making it literally disappear in Italy and hitting it hard in other countries. Luckily, the France Unsubmissive is in opposition, and we're still waiting for the results, and we'll talk probably in your next edition about the results. Sure, we'll see you next time. Once we know what went on with the elections, we would like to see you again. Thank you for joining us from Paris. Let's see, something that Christian was saying. The axis, the French-Germany axis, where will it lead?
Son una bomba de tiempo.
Are they a time bomb? This couple between Merkel and Macron, is it working, not working? And what's going to happen with Merkel on her way out and Macron with a decline in his popularity?
Es por eso que la aritmética, como decíamos, resultante de las parlamentarias europeas,
this is why the math in the number of people who are in the parliament makes a difference. Let's make a last pause and we'll see our last analysts. Don't go.
France, as with Germany, is part of the most powerful group in the European Parliament.
Sobre todo a principios de 2019,
at the beginning of 2019, there was a treaty signed between these two countries and consolidated this junction.
El eje franco-alemán busca
the axis, the French-German axis, is trying to become the leader of this organization. That's why they both support the creation of a European military force. For France, a very important time will be the elections, because the French delegation is one of the biggest, only heightened by the German one.
Son los que más representan
with Spain,
la integración europeísta. Sin embargo,
represent the integration of Europe. However, there's going to be a strong dispute
una fuerte disputa con el resto de las naciones en las que han triunfado nacionalistas
countries
de derecha que rechazan la integración regional.
Have gone for nationalist position.
Estados Unidos, últimamente Francia ha tenido
and lately France
Donald Trump rechazó categóricamente la
has had problems with
la Unión Europea
the US
instituya un ejército propio. Incluso señala
because the US says that the European Union should not have a military force of their own.
Que vive Francia.
He said that it was just a way to distract attention.
Luego de que la Casa Blanca se retirara del tratado INF de fuerzas nucleares de alcance intermedio.
After the US withdrawal from the nuclear treaty
fue firmado en 1987.
It was that was signed in 1987 by Ronald Reagan and Gorbachev.
Un campo de batalla ante un eventual choque entre ambas superpotencias. Al retirarse Estados Unidos,
but since the U.S. withdrew, the old continent is now exposed. That's why Macron believes that there should be a joint military operation. In Paris, we have Francisco Peña Torres, who is a teacher of Sciences Po and the Sorbonne. I would like you to answer. What are the points of differences between France and Germany, which is now exposed? Well, in fact, as you know, the European Union it was formed on the base, among other things, of joining the efforts of production. Bearing in mind the destruction that they had suffered some years before, and they thought that it was possible to advance in a political union, that they thought that joining economic interest of coal and iron and steel, they thought that maybe there could have been a European economic union. In time, some other ideas surfaced that advanced, especially in France and Germany, because they were the both biggest countries who participated in the European Union and the most affected by the Second World War. And in this sense, they advanced in the idea to assisted this was the U.S.
Que participaron en la creación de la Unión Europea. Eran simplemente, como lo ha revelado hace
they
una semana, cosa que todo el mundo sabía, eran agentes pagados por la central de inteligencia
they even had,
de los Estados
the US
Unidos, que veía con
was working with
ojos
them
a la,
because they
la
did
independencia
not want,
de Francia y del general de Gaulle.
They did not want the independence of France with General de Gaulle.
Pero, sin embargo,
however,
la Unión Europea
the European Union has advanced.
Los roces
and these frictions
en estos momentos,
that we're seeing now between
Merkel
Mrs. Merkel
Macron,
and Mr. Macron are just differences that have to do
cada uno se hace del rol,
with what they think the role
sus países
that their own respective countries should have within the European Parliament.
Y los otros países con los cuales la Unión Europea mantiene relaciones especiales, con los Estados Unidos, pero también con Rusia y con China. Hay una diferencia.
There's a difference, a fundamental difference.
Como se ha dicho,
because as it's been said, the accord of the European Union has guaranteed peace for several decades. It has also guaranteed
en detrimento
the enriching of Germany,
in
detriment of France and other European countries. So the frictions continue, because since you mentioned this topic about the European,
se avanzó la idea de crear una fuerza de la Unión Europea.
There used to be an idea of
fueron, having con mucha fuerza por el general de Gaulle y los golistas,
some ideas that were combated by de Gaulle.
Entonces, hay diferencias,
so there are differences. These differences can be made even more profound.
Merkel,
but
Mr.
Macron and Mrs. Merkel
una idea
have an idea of continuing
de Europa, una Europa unida y avanzar,
and strengthening
ellos,
Europe.
Tienen la idea de avanzar a la
construcción
de una Europa federal.
Of consolidating a federal Europe.
A la elección que
this will go to elections that happens in the next days.
This
election doesn't attract too many people.
The
winning party
será
will be
la abstención.
The abstention, people who don't go and vote. Obviously, this says a lot about the interest, the lack of interest of many European countries on this topic about the European Union. Let me ask you now, what do you think the United States government is betting on?
Bueno, en la Unión Europea,
well, the European Union,
digo,
as I told you, was a creation
Unidos,
of the United States, or at least with a contribution, with a fundamental contribution of the United States, as a way
mantener un bloque,
to maintain
a block
that opposes the threat of the moment, which at that point was Russia. That's why NATO was also created in
1949.
And 6 years later, the Varsovia Pact. In the years 1991,
the Varsovia
Pact had dissolved, although it really hasn't.
Nuevos objetivos, ¿no?
OEA has determined new objectives. Within the current debate in France about the European Union, there are several parties that support the withdrawal of France from the European Union. However, these parties
are,
in a curious way, they're right parties, like the group of Ms. Le Pen, and the Communist Party, and
Submissive
France. But on the other side, they've got different postures on the inside. They don't have the same position on being in the European Union and keeping the euro as the currency. The United States is interested that the European Union is able to pay for themselves, pay for their own defense budgets,
OTAN, quien dice OTAN, dice los
and they could,
Unidos,
they could also support NATO.
Uno de los puntos fundamentales de
this is one of the main points of the program.
Trump, que desea, entonces, que los europeos
that would like the Europeans
su defensa,
assume
solo,
their own defense.
Que contribuyan del punto
and if not
vista,
totally, at least that they could
mayor,
be able to pay for some part of it in a higher scale.
And that, pagar
and that doesn't make the American taxpayer pay
de
for the defense of Europe.
Tiene que ver This also has to do with the new vision
that Trump has exposed
in relationship of the other two blocks,
which is Russia and China.
In that regard,
they have a different position
from the European Union.
For example, how to treat Iran. And the attitude.
El gobierno de los Estados Unidos no es la misma que la Unión Europea.
The attitude
la relación
towards Iran
con Rusia
is different
tampoco
towards Iran, towards Russia, in regards to the U.S. and the European Union.
Como está enfrascado en una guerra comercial con China, tampoco es la misma.
And it's not the same with China either because of their economic struggle, economic feud they have with China.
Que aplica la Unión Europea.
So they will not have the same position they have like the European Union. What the U.S. wants is to have a zone.
There is
peace and tranquility where to operate. And in second place, the possibility
puedan asumir como personas mayores y niños grandes, digamos, su
the
propia
party, defensa. The countries in the European Union can assume their own defense.
Hasta pronto.
Thank you very much for your time.
Despedimos a nuestro último analista y pasamos a nuestras ideas.
Okay, let's go to our conclusions.
El de Macron, un personaje ligado a la banca,
Macron
una corta carrera política
is, has
por el capital financiero todo
a short history, a short political history, and he's very close to the banks.
Y uno de los peores evaluados en
and he's one of the worst evaluated for his work, although he does have an electoral base that support him, because anyway he's confronted with a group of parties who do not have good reputation either. So he may have good elections in the European Union. There might be a recomposition like the one in Latin America. However, this is, we still don't see a good perspective for the left. Let's see what happens with the elections. Thank you very much for following us. Have a nice afternoon.